The clients, they should get their import cargo and ship out the export cargo all year round with us. If we want to be here to serve our clients all year round without any limitations, we have to have Super 1A. We are allowed to be in the most tough ice conditions here in Bay of Bothnia, so we don't have any limitations regarding the season of the year. I mean, we can be here all the time, so we're safe and we're fulfilling all requirements. We have to be honest, this is a totally new generation of size of vessels in this area during the ice season, because we are, like, say, at least 25 to 30% longer than many other vessels. We are about 10 meters wider than the other largest vessel during ice season, also 10 meters wider than most of the icebreakers. So, of course, that the challenge would be that there was a lot of ice pressure on our hull, but we have just been keep on going, so the hull design has been very successful, we have to say, in combination with the engine power.
They need to and are required to be more powerful. The ice class rules for this vessel would say that we would need an engine of approximately 13,500 kilowatts. Now we have a little bit of more than that. We have two engines of about 10,000 kilowatts each. We have also the option to use PTI boost. PTI, that means power take in, so we can actually supply some extra power from our auxiliary engines going to the shafts. This extra kind of power is needed when the conditions get really tough, and we need to really put all the power we have into getting just the ship to move a little bit ahead.
Even if we're an ice class vessel ourselves and we can handle most of the situation by ourselves, we still need icebreakers in this area. They will always run the tracks. We could handle most of the things ourselves, but it takes more time. It costs more money because we're spending more energy and fuel, which is not good for the environment either. So icebreakers will always be needed in this area. From the beginning of January, the ice starts building up, and sometimes during the month of May, the last parts are melting away when we have nice weather and sunshine. The ice can be building up by itself because of the temperature all the time, but it's also living quite much. The wind is pushing the ice, and sometimes there are different parts of ice also colliding with each other. That can create quite big ridges of many, many meters. That is the reason why we also need icebreakers, because even for them, it's a challenge to go through the thickest ridges.
We have a lot of hull reinforcements, several meters above and below the waterline. We have a lot of extra frames, and also the plate thickness is much thicker. We have two strong propellers and rudders.
We have the two propellers here. So when we do the port maneuvering, the benefit is that we can go reverse with one propeller and we can go ahead with other one. So we can flush the ice, so we can clear the ice between the vessel and the berth. So we really get alongside. That is one of the really big benefits that we feel now at the ice season, at least. The pilots, they're coming aboard even now in the ice season. It's more difficult for them, but they will get aboard in one or another way. They join us into the port here, and then they do some of the communication. And once we reach the port, then I take over and do the maneuvering and so on.
Yeah, the first season in the ice is now coming to an end, and the engines has performed very well. So the hull design has proven to work very well in these conditions. And for instance, this morning, it looks tough out there, but we made it in there using only 40% engine power, and she goes like a knife through butter.